Welcome again. In this video, we are going to prove 5 new equalities. So let's get straight started. First, we have A intersection with B minus C is equal to A intersection B minus A intersection C. So now, taking the RHS, A intersection B minus A intersection C. Now by the very definition of symmetric difference, this becomes intersection with A intersect this whole complement. Applying the De Morgan's law, it becomes this A complement union C complement. Now applying the distributive law, it becomes this A intersection B intersection with A complement. That whole union with A intersection B intersection with C complement. Now look at this, A intersection with A complement. A has nothing common with this complement, so this whole term would become phi, and hence this becomes phi or an empty set union A intersection B intersection C complement. So looking further, phi with union, this whole just vanishes and becomes A intersection B intersection C complement. And now regrouping the terms, and if you identify that one is in that in the bracket one, it is our symmetric difference, and it becomes A intersection B minus C, and we prove this one. So moving on to the next one, and that is going to be really big. If you see, we have A union B minus A intersection B, and that is equal to A minus B union B minus A. If you would draw that in a Venn diagram, all this inequality would be very clear, but you know, we have to prove it analytically. So now taking RHS, A minus B union B minus A, and that is equal to A intersection B complement union B intersection with A complement. And now we are going to distribute them. So A intersection B complement union with B, that whole intersection with A intersection B complement intersection with A complement. And now, actually sorry, union with A complement. And now moving further, again applying the distributive law, it becomes A union B intersection B union B complement intersection A union A complement intersection A complement union B complement. And now moving further, if you see, this becomes our universal set, this also becomes our universal set. We are left at A union B intersection universal set intersector universal set intersection A complement union B complement. And taking in common with the universal set doesn't have any effects, it's the identity of it. If you know, A union B intersection A complement union B complement is now what it becomes. So if you see here, we can apply the De Morgan's law, A union B intersection A intersection B whole complement. And now if you recognize, this is what is the definition of symmetric difference. So A union B minus A intersection B, and we proved that we have started with this and ended in this one. Moving on to the third one, it says that A union B minus C is equal to A minus C union B minus C. And now let's not take the LHS, A union B minus C By definition, it is A union B intersection C complement. Applying the distributive law, A intersection C complement union B intersection C complement. Now, by the very definition of symmetric difference, this is A minus C union B minus C. And voila, you have proved this one also. And now the fourth one. This is that A union B and intersection A union B complement equal to A. If you have solved, you might be surprised by the simplicity of it. And you know, I got a bit trouble with this. But now, if you just straight away apply the distributive law, now what you see is that A and A here is common, so we can just take out that A and it becomes A union with B intersection with B complement, and now they have nothing in common with them, so A union phi, and that is A. Yes, it is that very simple. And now we proceed to our last one, and that is our fifth one, that A union B is equal to A minus B union B minus A union A intersection B. And if you see the Venn diagram, it is something that you ought to be knowing. This is our Venn diagram, A and B. A union B. A union B is actually all this region in between. And looking at all this region, you might feel that A minus B, well, it's this region. Union with B minus A, that's this region. Union with A intersection B, that's this region. They are equal, but not that way we are going to do it. We are going to do it analytically. And now, if you see, if we move on to our previous second one we proved. As you can see here, A minus B union B minus A is actually equal to A union B minus A intersection B. And we can apply that. We have got that there. So now, taking the RHS, we have that. We know that A minus B union B minus A is actually equal to A union B minus A intersection with B. So, taking that into account, we can transform the RHS into A union B minus A intersection B, and that whole union with A intersection B. We know what the definition of the symmetric difference is. It becomes A union B intersection A intersection B whole complement. And that whole is going to be union with A intersection B. Now, using the distributive law, it becomes A union B union with A intersection B. And that whole is intersection with A intersection B complement union A intersection B. And now if you look at this, this essentially becomes our whole set S, the universal set. And so it becomes A union B union A intersection B, and that whole intersection with S, so it literally disappears. And now we have got this. Now look at it. A union B, that whole big thing, and along with it, we are including A intersection B. Now this A intersection B is actually a subset of A union B. So unioning it with that already big set doesn't make any difference. So this is going to be A union B, and we have proved that also.